I'm using Primo. This can also work with the other polymer clays. The red I'm using is pomegranate, and then I mix it with half translucent because red is very highly saturated and it tends to leave its color all over your fingers. Mixing it with half translucent reduces that by a lot. So the red log, you just roll out polymer clay into a log, and you are rolling the white out to 1.7 centimeters. You're going to roll out two reds at 1.1 centimeter. And I go ahead and position those first. Those are directly across from each other, half and half. So I'm pressing those in slightly, making sure it's halfway on the other side too. Now from here, you are going to need six white, which is 0.8 centimeter, and you're going to need four red, which is 0.55, like it's almost six, not quite six. So it's 0.6 of a centimeter almost, but not quite. What I do is take two of the red and try to evenly space them so you have white on either sides. And the white actually fills in those spaces. And you just want to try to keep it even. That rolled on me a little bit. So we fill in the little white area, press it down. And this should take up just a little bit more than half of the bottom one. If any of them are a little too fat, you can elongate them to fit them in. So that is a little bit over half. So we get a wide red stripe and two thin ones when we roll it out. So we have those guys with space between. Then it's time to add the white. And the length doesn't matter so much, it's more of the width that matters. I'm going to throw this one in here real quick. That one got a little narrow there. I'm going to even it out. And then we place the last one in. Extra edges. And then I'm going to squeeze. So that is our candy cane cane. You just want to try to make sure that there's no air in the center, which is why I'm squeezing this. Okay. So from here, I just continue to roll it out thin. When it starts becoming too wide to roll on my sheet of paper, I chop, put half of it aside, and roll my next portion until it gets to that point. So I'm going to continue rolling till it gets smaller, and I continue to roll it until I get the thickness I want of the candy cane. And then I twist it to get the exact stripes I want. So when I was little, the candy canes that we always had a thick stripe of red with two thin stripes of red between. So that's why I do it in a cane, so we can control that. And then to make the candy cane, I just fold it. Make it the shape that I want to make it. And then just decide on the length that you want. With it being a candy cane, you don't have to be perfect. Now this is pretty large. You don't want to go too much smaller for this if you want to make a charm, because if you go too much smaller, you will crack the clay when you try to slide in the metal. So this is probably about as small as you want to get for the charms if you want to make candy cane charms. Now for the peppermint candy sticks, you just twist. And you can bake it and then cut them into the lengths you want. Or you can cut them before baking them. I prefer to cut after. It's easier to bake them straight if it's in a length. And I'll show you that in a sec. I'm just trying to put some twist in here. Okay. So, when I put it in the oven, I pull out from both edges and press it against my baking surface, press it flat to keep it in a straight line. Then when I'm done baking it, I will go chop, 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 chop for how many ever peppermint sticks I would want. So what we will do here though, is I will make it a little bit smaller so you can see a smaller candy cane. But I find I get the most out of my candy canes if I just fold it from the very end. Now the other cool thing about candy canes with the shape is you can actually make some of these little guys, cook them, and if you cook them in the right shape, you could make two, have them facing each other, and have a little candy cane heart as a decoration for like a cupcake, and it could even get smaller than this too, guys.